Hey everyone, I'm Bree. Welcome to my channel. Today I have a holiday romance book haul. Some of these are ones that I have hauled and then some of them have been sent to me by the publishers, so thank you to them. I am very excited for all of these, so let's just get into the books. First up we have A Cold Water Christmas, and this is by Dolores Fossen. Only other book that I've read by her is the holiday romance that she came out for this series with last year. This one is part of her Cold Water Texas series, follows Chase and Jaina, and it sounds like they were married before. She has remarried and has a kid, and she has come back to their Texas town to try to persuade her mom to not marry Case's dad. And it sounds like in the midst of all of that, they rekindle their relationship. I am very much looking forward to picking this one up. I loved the book that I read last year. I just did not get to backtracking with the series and reading all of the other books that were part of it. So I will definitely be doing that in 2020, but I am very much looking forward to this one. Next, I have Christmas in Winter Valley by Jodi Thomas, which is part of her Ransom Canyon series. This is another one where the last book that I read in the series was the holiday romance that came out last year. I did not get around to reading the previous books in the series, but I will be fixing that in 2020. I feel like the series that I did dedicate to actually backtracking and reading this year took up a lot of time this year, so I will have to definitely make it a goal to backtrack with these series so I know what all is going on. I'm really looking forward to this one. It follows Cooper and Elliot, and they are brothers, and it sounds like Cooper goes to like their family cabin and Elliot stays put to run the ranch, and they both have surprise visits. What I liked about last year's book was that she had like three different couples and it was just interweaving stories, but she really wove it all together nicely, so I'm really interested to see how this one works. Next, I have Christmas in Harmony Harbor, and this is by Debbie Mason. I've been seeing this book all over the place, and I know it's part of a series, so I was really nervous. Like, I don't want to pick it up and be totally confused, but I reached out to Estelle from Forever Publishing, and I was like, will I be confused if I haven't read any of the previous books? And she's like, you'll be fine. That one definitely feels like it can be read as a standalone, so shout out to Estelle. So yes, I was at the grocery store and I picked it up because here in Texas, HEB has a romance section. So I'm so happy to finally have this one. Next, I have Holiday by Candlelight, and this is by Laurel Greer. And this one is a Hanukkah romance. I have not read a Hanukkah romance. And this one follows Dr. Caleb Matsuda. And it sounds like he's a surgeon and he's in an avalanche accident, which robs him from his ability to do his job. And then he meets Garnet James, and she's part of like a search and rescue team, and he starts having feelings for her, but knowing like what she does, it causes some conflict. I cannot wait to get to this one. Again, I have never read a Hanukkah romance, so I'm very excited for it. This next one, I was so excited when it arrived, and that is Rancher's Wild Secret by Maisie Yates. Maisie Yates is my queen, you guys. If you are into cowboy romances, you have to read Maisie Yates. She is just wonderful, and she has made me fall in love with cowboy romances. I love just the hard work and the work ethic these guys have. It's amazing. And the females work just as hard, and that's what I love about it. It's like an equal playing field. But I don't know much about this. I just was like, it's a new Maisie Yates holiday romance. I have to have it. Next is Stealing Kisses in the Snow by Joe McNally. I know that this one follows a single mom. I don't read very many like single parent romances, but the ones that I do, when they are holiday romances, I feel like they are just so sweet and done very well. So that's all I want to know going into this one. I'm very excited to pick it up and see what I think. This next one is one that I bought at the grocery store, and that is Cowboy Christmas Homecoming by June Favor. This is part of her Dark Horse Cowboy series. Know about this one is that it follows our hero Zach, and he has PTSD. Sounds like now that he's out of the military, he's back doing ranch work. I am so excited. When I was in the military, I kind of basically refused to read military romances because I wasn't sure if they would be done right. But now that I'm out of the military, I definitely want to give them a try. So I'm super excited to finally read this one. I hauled it like weeks ago, and it's taken everything in my power to not pick it up. Next, we have Low Country Christmas by Lee Tobin McLean. I have not read anything by this author. It sounds like, I don't know if she has custody of her niece or what, but Her niece's only Christmas wish is to track down her dad. Holly tracks him down and he's in this small town of Safe Haven. I guess this is part of the Safe Haven series. And he's not what she was expecting him to be. Next we have The Giving Heart, and this is by Tony Blake. And this follows Lila. And she goes and house sits for her sister Meg. And there's this guy Beck, and he's basically going around cutting trees off of people's property. And she has to stop him because she knows her sister is not going to be having that. And this is their romance. I am very excited to get into it and see what I think. Shout out to Harlequin for sending me this. I have All I Want for Christmas Is You by Miranda Liason. This one follows Caitlin and Rafe, and it sounds like just when Caitlin tells herself like to get over him, they have a sizzling night together and she gets pregnant. This one has been all over the place and I've been hearing wonderful things, so I'm so happy to finally have it. I cannot wait to start it. And the last one is one that the author sent to me, so shout out to Jane Porter. This is Oh Christmas Night. The cover is absolutely gorgeous. So this follows Rachel, and she inherits this bookstore back in Montana, and she just kind of goes with the impulse, books a ticket, goes to Montana to check out the building. And then we have Texas lawyer Atticus Bowen, who he wants to open up a restaurant in the town, and all he needs to do is persuade Rachel, the new owner of the bookstore, to sell him the bookstore so he can put his restaurant there. I feel like I'm gonna love this. I love when heroines inherit a building. Usually it's like a bed and breakfast. So when I saw that this one was a bookstore, I was like, oh, that's gonna be really good. And then the hero wanting to use that building to open a restaurant. Books and food, two of my favorite things. I feel like I'm gonna love this one. Shout out to Jane Porter for sending me a copy. So that is my holiday romance book haul. Let me know if you have read any of these yet and what your thoughts were on them, which one you think that I should start with first. There are so many and they all sound so wonderful. Or please, what was the last book that you hauled? Let me know down in the comments below. I would love to hear. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you in my next video. Have a good day. Bye.